Hello, this is Aidu San from B equal to IR. So today we are discuss about the path fault relay. So this is our kit and this is our relay. So generally that is our fault simulation kit. We inject the same value of current in the field site. This CT current is coming from the field side, but here we connect in fault simulation kit, and this is our relay. So here basically there are two types of coil inside. First is a disc coil, and the second one is our pickup coil. When CT, suppose in the field, this two wire is connected with CT secondary, and this is connected with our breaker. So when the fault is coming in our field area, the secondary current will come to this relay, and when the secondary current is more than our setting value, that time this disc is start rotating, and due to rotation, this disc will make the contact and pick the breaker. So first we should know the theory part, how it's worked. So here we go. So basically this relay is our standard inverse relay. Standard inverse relay, we need there's two values. That is our constant value, that is K and that is alpha. So in we should set first the TMS. The TMS value, that is we already set in our breaker 0.3, okay. So and PSM is our fault current divided by our set current, that is already calculated in 2. PSM is 2, and the set current is 0.75 ampere. I set here already, I set in 0.75. so that is our pickup current means pickup value means when the disc is start rotating, but not fully rotated, but start rotated, that is our pickup current. So and we inject here two times of set current, but in the field that fault current is created by natural hazards, maybe some line to line fault or something happened there that time. Not two times, maybe more than 5 or 20 times more current, but we inject here only two times. So that is our fault current 1.5. this 1.5 current we will inject from our fault simulation kit, okay. So now we will do the practical side.
You can see the inside of this relay, that is our disc coil. When we give CT supply, that fault current goes inside and it will start magnetized, and this magnetized is that whole magnetic flux is traveled through this core, and when this core is magnetized, this disc is start rotating. So when the disc is start rotating, when the disc is touch here that contact, so when this contact is closed, our tripping coil is switch on. When the tripping coil is on, that goes down. I think it's not working well, so it should be goes down like that. See, when this is trip, this flag is down, so that is permanent contact, and this signal is go to the breaker, that's it, and that breaker is tripped. Okay, thanks. So here you can see there is a some value, you can see here, that is our time multiplier setting, that is TMS. Now we set already 0.3 seconds, and our current settings I already set here is 0.75 amps. So that is our set current settings, and that is our TMS. Okay. So here you can see there is one
this key is not fixed properly. We have to push and fix properly, so the two contact will make perfectly.
So here now we are going to test our fault relay. So as I explained, this is our fault simulation kit. That is our CDG secondary that is connected in our relay. So first of all, that relay is same type. I just show you one thing. See, when we remove this relay, there is a this side is 910, that is connected to your field. That is CT secondary current will come. So if this is open, so heavy voltage is generated here. So okay, that is our interlock. When we remove the relay part, so this is directly shorted, because CT secondary is never open. We have to put always short. So now we are going to inject our pickup current, that is 0.75. So now you can see the closely. Pickup current is when the disc is start rotating. Just try to start rotating, that is our pickup current. So we just inject our 0.5 set current. Okay. So we are now injecting 0.75 amp, slowly increase. Increase 0.75. Now you see the disc. You see here the disc is slowly rotating. That means we got our pickup current. So now stop. So now we are create. Now we should create our fault. So fault is now we are injecting two times of our set current. So fault current is 1.5 amps. Now we are injecting here. So okay, start from simulation kit and set the current is 1.5 ampere. Okay, just set. Okay, we already set. Okay, start 1.5. Okay, increase. One, just set 1.5 and stop. Okay, stop. Now we already set our fault. Now we just generate our fault. So when the fault, now we are just give the to relay our fault scenario. When we start, that fault current is go to the relay, and relay is our relay disc, that is disc is start rotating and start rotating and make contact with tripping coil. So now we are going to give fault. Now we are going to give our fault current here. Now you see the disc. You see the disc here. When I start, okay, see, that is our fault current, 1.5. So we have to go in close, so we can see easily how it's working. Now I am going to inject. So be concentrated here. So okay, start. Start 1, 2, 3. Okay, that is our 1.5 current, and this is going to trip. See, that flag is showing that our relay is already tripped. So now you see our timing. The correct timing is 3.73 seconds, but our calculated time is 3 seconds. So here is the whole discussion about earth fault relay. Okay, if you have any doubt in this relay, just give comment. And if you like our videos, just share it, comment it, and like it. Okay, thanks for watching. This is Zahid Hussain.
So if you want to join with us, you can contact through Facebook. This is our Facebook page. We have a wide range of protective relays. Or if you want to contact with us, you can direct call to this number